Welcome to Reykjavik Grapevine's newscast. My name is Valur Grettisson. I'm an editor-in-chief at Reykjavik Grapevine. You can find my name down there if you can't spell it, like you can't understand how I'm saying it. Not the first one to not hear my name correctly. So we're here. It's Volcano Cast. We're a day late. The reason is simple. It was like a horrible weather yesterday, so it was like it would have not been good for anyone if we would gone to the mountain. We would have gotten very wet, and you would not get a nice view of the volcano. But we're going to the volcano, and it's it's actually more powerful now than often before. It's getting back its strength, but it's not the same strokes like the fire geyser, but it's different. And we're gonna see how it is. We haven't seen it yet. What I want to show you just before we go up there is that this farm here, this farm is called Ísólfsstaðaskáli. Ísólfur is a name, and it's like a skáli is like an old name for a land. The thing is that this place here will very likely end up under the lava, because if Art can follow me here, you can see the strokes from the volcano just right over there. This is the road here. And if you want directions, this is the city, it's over there. So, the lava, when it reaches the road, it will pretty likely come down here, probably down these hills here, and in the end go over this land, which is a damn shame. Perhaps the good news, not that there is any good news in this, is that there are no farmers here. They went away 30 years ago, but there are like around 30 people like that that inherited this earth here, and they are using this as summer house and sometimes for tourism and such, but not now. This is a private land, so if you come to Iceland, it's still here. Don't be venturing into this land. They don't want that, the owners. Also, this land here is pretty historic, because Ísólfur, which is like an old, not Viking, we were not all Vikings, some of us were just farmers. His grave was actually somewhere around there where the volcano came up. And archaeologists, they were actually looking for his grave when the volcano started, but they didn't find it, meaning that up there his grave is somewhere under the lava. This land here has been used like, I think the first farmers were here in the 1700s. And they lived here more or less from 1700 to like 1990. Before that, Icelanders used this land for up to 1,000 years to go down there to the ocean and fish. And you can even see there are like very old fish barracks around here, not 1,000 years old, but they're quite old. So this land has been very like giving to the people that lived here, and it's beautiful, and it will be like, it will be a shame when it's gone. There's a lot of foxes here, a lot of bird life, but it's pretty evident when the lava goes over here that there will not be much life, and everybody needs to move. The animals, of course. So it's changing a lot, this area. Scientists now think this is gonna become a sealed mountain. This is like becoming more evident now. If it's gonna be a sealed mountain, this will definitely go under, and the lava will definitely get into the sea. This is not much of a concern. I've seen some comments about this. Nothing is going to explode or anything. It's perhaps going to be a little bit more ash, but it's not going to be that much of a hassle. But what's a hassle is that Grindavík could be in danger, and even the main road which is used to go to the Keflavík airport. So there's a lot at stake here. But more about that, we're going to hike to the mountains, show you the greatest show on earth. And before we do that, remember, of course, our online shop, our sponsor, Einstök Beer. You can find them at einstökbeer.com. And let's go. Do you think you're gonna hear me, or?
What?
You think you're gonna hear me?
Yeah, watch out.
We're here on Path C. As you can see and hear, perhaps, it's very, very windy. It's a little bit almost hard to stand here. Hard to have my glasses on, they could just go off anytime. For some reason, this valley here, Nauta, is very windy. It's always like this here. I don't know why. You've seen this before, of course. So, this is the newest path we're on right now. You can see here, we walk onwards over there. And over there is, like, all on the, like, the end there is Litli Hrútur, or Little Ram. And we're actually heading over there because then we can see this volcano over there. The reason I want to show you this place is because you can actually see a lot of things at the same time. You can see the volcano here, which is pretty impressive, of course. The lava in Nautaí, and then you can see Grindavík as well as the road. So, Grindavík is not that far away. What's more, the town council of Grindavík, they have decided that they are not going to save this road. The reason is pretty simple and as banal as they can be. It's just way too expensive, and they're not even sure if they're going to make it anyway. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, forgive me about the wind. I'll do my best here. So, the thing is that it cost around $1 to $2 million, or around 200 million Icelandic krona, just to make this road here, save the road. And there is no guarantee how that will go. So, this is the road. On this side here, that's where Ísólfsstaðaskáli was. I showed you, we began the video there, so you can see how close all of this is, actually. Of course, the lava just keeps on flowing down. It's still producing like 9 football fields every day. So you can even see if you go a little bit, if you're not afraid of height, if you're afraid of height, stop watching now, but if you're not, then you can see here, when we were last time we were here, and we went to Nauta, then you can see this brown area there called Óbrinnisholmi. We were standing we went down that road there, and we were shooting there in the edges of the lava, and from the end of the brownish area, there was no lava there. So you can see in a week it's just crawling like crazy, I guess, all the way towards the road. So let's get out of the wind, but it's not going to get any better, I think. So me and Arthur are going to hike a little bit closer to the mountain and show you, we're going to try to show you Meradalir as well. So follow us. So, we finally found a place that was not as windy as the other ones. I was actually with very nice gentlemen from Atlanta, Georgia. One of them had this gadget and he could see the wind, and it was 17 miles per hour, not meters. I don't know what 70 miles are, but perhaps someone can tell us. And it was pretty hard to stand in the worst wind. Also, it's it's quite cold here, but it's sunny, and the weather can be deceiving in that way. It's when in Iceland, when you get into the mountains, it's always very different kind of weather. So always I know this altitude seems a little bit too much sometimes, but it's exactly the right, trust me. But what I want to tell you right now is that, oh my God. Yeah, influences in the wild, I guess. people are still actually going to the lava for some reason. The police is quite annoyed by this. And the search and rescue teams have issued that they will try to save you, but they will not put themselves in danger. Meaning, if you go into the lava, let's say just something breaks and your foot go off into the hot lava, which is 1,000 degrees, by the way, and Celsius. Then nobody's going to get you until the helicopter comes and gets you up from there. Nobody's going to walk on the lava towards you. So this is, you can see, incredibly stupid. But hopefully this is beginning to cool down, but you never know. So But this mountain there is now officially 3 months old. And what does this mean? This means that this is... Jesus, should we say something to them or... Okay. That means that this lava here is 3 months old. And the most amazing thing is that it has been so different in so many ways. Geologists are quite surprised by the changes of the nature of this volcano. It gone from this small fissure eruption to 8 fissures at the same time. Or was it 9? We never quite got the number right. But there was a lot of them. Number 3 used to be huge. But then it all changed into this one incredibly massive fire geyser. And then even that changed, the pulses became different. And now it just pushes the lava very heavily out. And the thing is that all geologists say now, this is most definitely a sealed volcano. And what does that mean? Well, it means that the time period for a volcano like that is from just 1 year or less up to 50 to even 200 years historically. So if this sealed volcano will be here for, let's say, 50 years, volcanologists, they have said it's pretty evident that they will reach the town of Grindavík as well as the power plant, hydro power plant. Geothermal power plant, in Svartsengi. And that's the one that the Blue Lagoon actually gets its water from. It's hot water, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just extra water that comes from the earth, and hence the odd blue color of it. So Grindavík might be wiped out within 50 years, which will not make them as happy as they used to be before, that's for sure. Hey, you know that's dangerous, right?
Sorry?
You know this is dangerous, right?
I don't understand, sorry.
You know this is dangerous?
I know.
Okay. They just don't care. Well, anyways. But I bet this is gonna be an incredible Instagram post and definitely worth it when it happens. Anyway. Sealed volcano, meaning that this will, even where we are, these mountains here, they will probably go almost onto this. This volcano would just go off and off and off, and you will have a huge pool of lava on top of it, and it will push down to these lava tubes, channels, whatever you call this. In Icelandic, it's tunnels, gung. Also, another interesting thing about this volcano here, it produces two different kinds, finish the sealed volcano. It hasn't happened in Iceland since Ice Age, which is basically around 6,000 or 7,000 years ago. So this is quite the event. It also, what geologists say is odd, not odd, but it's pretty special in Iceland that it actually produces two kinds of lava. It produces this ropey lava, which is what do you call it? Poi hoi hoi. I can never say this word correctly. But it's ropey lava, and it's the smooth one. And then they have the other one, which is block lava. And it produces this sometimes the block lava, sometimes the other. And you can see it actually here. This is actually a fantastic way to see it. You can see the foi hoi hoi here, and then you can see the block lava, the reddish lava over here. So it's going to be a different kind of lava fields here, not just with this gray, smooth stone kind of lava. Which is beautiful to watch at least. Also, the volcano, of course, is going to be quite steady, have been quite steady, and will be quite steady. Meaning that the source of the lava is so deep that it can go off for basically ever. Theoretically, I think that's basically it. Check it out, more people. There are always some sheep. One goes onto the lava, more people go up there. And now these two, they will probably go up there also. Keep in mind, this is like incredibly dangerous. You know this, I'm always saying this. It's like just like volcano doesn't kill anyone. It's just like people being silly kills themselves somehow. So if something happens here, I mean, we have definitely then the first serious incident because of this volcano, and it will not go well either for the person that actually had happened to, or the ones that want to visit it afterwards. Yeah. But yeah, the water. The water here, I mentioned this, of course, like some weeks ago, like months ago, when this lava, when the earthquakes were like going very loudly, and they were just shaking everything. We were concerned about the water in Grindavík and in this area. The thing is, because this area is so new and it's such a young land, it's meaning that, like, not here, of course, but on the other side, there is like very clean water under all of this lava, meaning that we use this water to drink it because Iceland is very rich of water. But the thing is that all of this here, what's happening, could actually threaten this in the future. The people of Svartsengi, the geothermal plant, which actually they watch out for the water and measure that and such. They say there is no pollution in the water and like yet, not gas or ash or anything, because of course this is not ash like volcano. So it's like it's still fine, but I think it could be only a matter of time until that will be in danger. So this is a very slow event. It's 3 months old, and imagine like 3 months from now, it will be still going on. It's pretty sure that, I mean, it's obvious that this happens much faster than you would think. For Icelandic geologists, it's just amazing to be able to see how these shield mountains just form. And it's interesting for us just to cover it. But what we're gonna do now, we're gonna go up to this mountain. Art doesn't want to, but I'm not gonna give him any option for this. He's very tired. We just hiked this path C, and it's a little rougher than the others, but not as rough as path B. But I have to say, this is a very fun hike. So for us at least, just remember to go slow and all of that. But we're gonna go up there and we're gonna try to show you Meradalir. Okay, so, well, of course there's a helicopter. Whoa! You could do it like a little kid, you could always like... Anyway, the wind is insane, meaning that we are on the next highest peak, I think, in the area. The highest peak is in Keilir, but I'm gonna show you a little bit before. You can see over there, there is like a small town you can see there, and that is Reykjanesbær or Keflavík. So, if you look here, you can see Grindavík over there. And if you turn with me, we can see Reykjavík over there. And of course, the volcano is here, and it's absolutely spectacular from this view here. So I definitely recommend that you would go to this big mountain. It's no easy hike here, but if you do it, it's absolutely crazy. If it's not as windy as it is now, then it's gonna be insane. But we're not done yet. I'm gonna show you Meradalir. We haven't seen it for a very long time. And we were actually quite confused when we were looking over the area. The reason is basically because there is no Meradalir anymore. It's just filled with lava. The Fagradalsfjall is just eating the place up, and as you can see, as you follow us, it's double the size I thought this lava was. So you can see it's way down here, and it's just breathtaking to see this. And over there you can see like the big mountain in the distance. That's Keilir, that's the biggest one. A wonderful mountain, I love it, I hike it often. And this lava is obviously, well, getting there. But the thing is, like I said, if this is a sealed volcano, which it most likely is, and if it will go off for 50 years, which it could, but we hope not, actually, it means that this area, whole area here, with like a very large like ring scale, will basically go under lava and then just push up and up and up and up. And this will always be the source unless, of course, it changes or even duplicates. We never know. So these here, small mountains, used to be mountains and now just little more than hills. They're probably gonna go more or less under the lava. And yeah, it's just, it's something to behold, man. Okay. The wind is becoming quite bad. I don't have more to say. This has been a wonderful day, a brilliant hike. I love this hike. So choose path C if you're gonna come here. It's not harder or easier than path B, but you're gonna see much more, and you can see it from a very diverse, from a diverse angles. Also, don't be an idiot. Don't be walking on the lava. That's it for me. Until next time, see you then. Whoa. Thank you.